Welcome to another video of the RShiny dashboard series. In this video, we're going to use ggplot to plot our chart. In the previous video, we created a bar plot using the default plotting library of R, and this is how the chart was looking like. As you can see, there's a lot of work to make it look good, and ggplot2 helps us do that. So let's see how we can create a chart using ggplot2. Now, I've taken the same code that we have in the previous video, and I pasted it here. The only thing that we're going to change is this particular plotting, right? So we're going to take this library ggplot2, and instead of bar plot df$sales, we're going to put another plotting system here. So let's look at some of the other things that are there here. We have Shiny as usual, dplyr as usual, ggplot, which is recently added. We'll take our input data, we'll summarize the information using dplyr, and then now we are going to plot it using ggplot instead of the default plotting library. The UI remains the same. The plot is what we are going to get as an output here. So let's cut out this one here. And I'm going to now introduce a variable called g, which is nothing but our plot. And then ggplot is the function that we'll be using. We'll be using df as an input. And then the aesthetics will be y, comma, x. The y is going to be sales and x is going to be quarter. Now this is not going to be sufficient for plotting it. To the g, we also need to add a geom bar, which will help us create the bar chart. So I'm going to say g plus, and then I'm going to say geom the score bar, open close bracket. And I'm going to give the stat sum here. Now this is ready. The app is ready. What we did is we replaced this bar plot with a ggplot2, and let's see how it's going to be looking like. I saved this code and I'm going to say run app. Now the chart looks much better. You have all your bars that are available. You have the labels, you have the sales, and the numbers look much more better and representative. So instead of using the default plotting libraries of R, we can use ggplot to enhance how the chart looks like. Now that we have gotten our chart in place, we need to make it dynamic in nature, and that's what we're going to explore in the next video. We're going to use Reactive and Render to get dynamic data and then plot it based on the user selection done on a drop down.